Hi guys, hallo Leute. Welcome back to German with Jenny. Today, I want to talk to you about subordinating conjunctions. Let's take a closer look. When you use a subordinating conjunction, the conjugated verb that follows the conjunction moves to the end of the clause. That's a very important piece of information, so you have to remember that. You also have to remember that you have to place a comma in front of the subordinating conjunction. Let's take a look at subordinating conjunctions in the present tense. Ich weiß, dass krank ist. This means I know that he's sick. Literally, what we're actually saying in German is I know that he sick is. Of course, that doesn't make any sense in English, but this is the word order in German. It's very common to hear the following mistake. Ich weiß, dass ist krank. But this is wrong. This is how you would say it in English, but this is not how you say it in German. In German, the verb moves to the end of the secondary clause, okay? Ich weiß, dass krank ist. I know that he's sick. Ich weiß, dass krank ist. Let's take a look at the next example. Ich weiß nicht, ob morgen zum Training kommt. I don't know whether he will come to practice tomorrow. Ich weiß nicht, ob morgen zum Training kommt. So as you can see in this sentence, we have the verb at the end. This is correct. It's wrong to say, ich weiß nicht, ob morgen kommt zum Training. The verb is not at the end in this clause, okay? So this is wrong. Ich weiß nicht, ob morgen zum Training kommt. I don't know whether he will come to practice tomorrow. Ich weiß nicht, ob morgen zum Training kommt. Let's take a look at the next example. Ist nicht da, weil auf Geschäftsreise ist. He's not there because he's on a business trip. Ist nicht da, weil auf Geschäftsreise ist. So as you can see, the verb is at the end of the sentence once again. I often hear beginners say, ist nicht da, weil ist auf Geschäftsreise. This is the English sentence structure, but in German you have to place the verb at the end, okay? So this is wrong. Ist nicht da, weil auf Geschäftsreise ist. He's not there because he's on a business trip. Ist nicht da, weil auf Geschäftsreise ist. Let's take a look at subordinating conjunctions with helping verbs. Wir sind drinnen geblieben, weil den ganzen Tag geregnet hat. We stayed inside because it rained all day. As you can see, we have the helping verb at the very end of the sentence. It's wrong to say, wir sind drinnen geblieben, weil hat den ganzen Tag geregnet. This, once again, is how you would say it in English. But in German, we have to place the helping verb at the end of the sentence, okay? Wir sind drinnen geblieben, weil den ganzen Tag geregnet hat. We stayed inside because it rained all day long. Wir sind drinnen geblieben, weil den ganzen Tag geregnet hat. Let's take a look at subordinating conjunctions with modal verbs. Ich weiß nicht, ob morgen zur Besprechung kommen muss. I don't know whether I have to come to the meeting tomorrow. Ich weiß nicht, ob morgen zur Besprechung kommen muss. So as you can see, the modal verb is at the end of the sentence. It's wrong to say, ich weiß nicht, ob muss morgen zur Besprechung kommen. This is the English sentence structure, but we have to place the modal verb at the end, okay? Ich weiß nicht, ob morgen zur Besprechung kommen muss. I don't know whether I have to come to the meeting tomorrow. Ich weiß nicht, ob morgen zur Besprechung kommen muss. Let's take a look at subordinating conjunctions with separable verbs. You have to separate separable verbs in the present tense, such as in the sentence. Bringt Wein mit. He's bringing wine. Bringt Wein mit. So the prefix mit is placed at the end of the sentence. However, if you use a subordinating conjunction, such as das, then you have to reattach the separable prefix at the end of the sentence, okay? So this is what it looks like. Hat gesagt, dass Wein mitbringt. He said that he's bringing wine. Hat gesagt, dass Wein mitbringt. All right, that's enough theory. Now let's take a look at some more examples. Wusstest du, dass er Sonja einen Heiratsantrag gemacht hat? Did you know that he proposed to Sonja? Wusstest du, dass er Sonja einen Heiratsantrag gemacht hat? As you can see in this sentence, the helping verb hat is at the end of the sentence. Ich bin mir nicht sicher, ob er mich verstanden hat. I'm not sure whether he understood me. Ich bin mir nicht sicher, ob er mich verstanden hat. Ich bin sauer auf ihn, weil er mich angelogen hat. I'm mad at him because he lied to me. Ich bin sauer auf ihn, weil er mich angelogen hat. Ich bin mir ziemlich sicher, dass er nächste Woche zurückkommt. I'm pretty sure that he's coming back next week. Ich bin mir ziemlich sicher, dass er nächste Woche zurückkommt. So we're using the separable verb zurückkommen. But here in this sentence we're using a subordinating conjunction. So we have to reattach the prefix at the end of the sentence. Zurückkommt. Ich weiß nicht, ob er mit uns kommen will. I don't know whether he wants to come along with us. Ich weiß nicht, ob er mit uns kommen will. So we're using a modal verb. And as we learned today, modal verbs have to go to the end of the sentence. Er kommt etwas später, weil er einen Arzttermin hat. He's coming a bit later because he has a doctor's appointment. Er kommt etwas später, weil er einen Arzttermin hat. We can see that the verb hat is at the end of the sentence. Remember to visit GermanWithJenny.com if you're looking for worksheets and exercises. And I will hopefully see you next time. Bis bald. Tschüss!